the seal. Align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see which ones?
Defined.
Line up the ravens.
If you hear the soul of Valravn, follow it, and it will lead you to him. But be aware of his illusions.
Valravn.
You can't always trust him.
Challenge me!
Winter, before the tragedy, she journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. We call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like Sin, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now.
She can get up now.
What's happening? She can get up now.
How can she get up?
It must be
magic.
Dark
magic.
A trick.
Valravn.
Tricking her.
Valravn.
How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him. Dark magic draws her closer.
Valravn's magic.
It's not
him. He's helping her.
It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it
on her own.
He's not tricking her.
It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Thank you.
think of a shadow in the woods? A creature in the night? If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
She can't get in. She can't go in there. Val Revan, he's there. She can't go in. Has to find another route.
Truth says there's always another route.
Find a way somewhere. Go round. Find your own path. There's a different way.
The Northmen say that Odin and his brothers killed Ymir, and that the world of men was formed from his corpse. They made his bones into stone, and his flesh into earth, and his blood into the salt sea. They set his skull to be the bowl of the sky, with his brains for clouds. Odin and his brothers caught the sparks flying from Muspel and made them into stars. And to protect the new world from the giants, they used Ymir's great curving eyebrows as walls.
Do you know what it's like to leave everything behind? Your home, loved ones, to head deep into the wilds, perhaps never to return. Senua does. Because when darkness speaks, it changes everything. Turning home into a foreign land and loved ones into strangers. Exile makes sense when you realize that you were never really home in the first place.
The Northmen say you must sacrifice in order to receive. They tell how the runes were revealed to Odin only in sacrifice. He hung himself from the world tree, and he stabbed himself with a spear, and he dedicated the sacrifice to himself. For 9 nights he hung on the tree without food or drink, and at last he saw the runes below him. He gave a cry and gathered them in his mind and learnt them. Then he fell from the tree.
A long time ago.
Why did she go to the wild?
She wanted to fight her own darkness. She thought she could beat her own darkness.
Did she beat her darkness?
No. It nearly killed her, but she tried.
Druth. Druth helped her.
If it wasn't for Druth, she'd be dead.
She can't beat her own darkness. She wanted to marry Dillian. She came to beat her own darkness. But it didn't work.
She thought her curse would affect him.
She thought her curse would spread to him. She thought she'd bring the darkness to him too. She nearly died.
She thought the curse made her tainted.
Druth helped her.
The ravens.
The ravens.
They've gone.
The sins have gone.
No.
Half of them have gone.
They've gone.
Some are still there.
But where?
Some are still there.
And Val Raven's helping.
Why is he? He's not helping.
It's a trick.
Quiet. It's a trick. Where have they gone?
Out in the wild. In the cold winter woods.
Where have they gone?
She no longer felt fit for this world. She almost gave in to the darkness. She remembered Dillian's words. She remembered her promise. She resolved to fight on and kill that which had become a part of her.
Thank you. Not for this.
The Northmen say that Odin is always in search of knowledge and wisdom and magic. There was a very wise being named Mimir who guarded the waters of wisdom which flow from the roots of the world tree. Odin wished to drink from this spring, but he had to pay a price. So he gouged out his own eye as offering to Mimir. He drank from the well and traded one way of seeing for another.
They were gone.
No. There's still three. There's three.
Where have they gone?
She did it. What does it mean?
Looking back, I was so naive to think she could banish it on her own. The further she saw into the darkness, the more she struggled to see anything at all. And the glow. The smallest hints of shape, sound, thought, grow in strength until they consumed her whole. Before she knew it, the darkness had her in its claws.